How's it going, guys? It's going to be a hyper short clip here. Difficult question, physiology endocrine for step one. If you think this is nitpicky or strange, don't take it up with me. Take it up with the USMLE. It's on the exam. Before we get started, please subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it. Give you a like, really appreciate it. Find me on Instagram, @_medical, and NHL, @_medical. Link below from your Telegram. Links to the Telegram group or channel down below. And I'll start the clip. 39-year-old astronaut who spent a year in space and he returns to Earth, and USMLE, for whatever fucking reason, wants to know some arrows about what we're going to see. Okay, so let's just hop through the answer choices here. Not going to be a lengthy clip, as I already said. So let's look at bone density first. Now, doesn't take a fucking rocket scientist, no pun intended. Let's make jokes, okay? Doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure out that if you've spent time in space where you're not using your bones, okay, your muscles and bones against the effects of gravity, that you're going to have decreased bone density, all right? So the same way you need to know for osteoporosis prevention in postmenopausal women that weight-bearing exercise helps preserve bone density, that applies here, where the effects of gravity, resistance on bone, helps maintain bone density. So in space where we have attenuated effects of gravity, we would have leaching of calcium out of the bone, so that's going to cause decreased bone density. So we're only looking at these bottom answer choices here. So let's look at muscle bulk. Obviously, it's a down arrow. Once again, doesn't take a fucking rocket scientist to figure out that your muscle bulk will be decreased because you're not using your muscles against gravity. All right, so OMG, the elephant in the room, looking at these last two answer choices, it's going to be up or down arrow for urinary CNP. Well, the factoid point you need to know is that for whatever reason, urinary CNP is increased in the setting of high PTH. Okay, we can talk about G protein effects and all that. Doesn't really matter. Okay, it's just, it's a factoidy piece of information that you could have known back in the day when we had the numerical step one that PTH can cause your increased urinary CNP. But pass fail step one now, they still want you to know the arrow for it. So in this situation, if we have calcium leaching out of the bone because we have decreased bone density when there's lesser gravity effects, then there's going to be increased calcium in the blood that will induce increased negative feedback at the calcium sensing receptors, the parathyroid glands. PTH could be suppressed relative to its theoretical baseline. So if PTH is slightly lower compared to its theoretical baseline, then urinary CNP should also decrease. So our answer is going to be decreased bone density, decreased muscle bulk, decreased urinary CNP. You know the deal. I'm going to make more content if you like my stuff. Subscribe my channel. Appreciate your time. That's it.